Hi, everybody. Hey, if med students can come grab a cider and a glass and bring it back for the toast. Oh, I guess this is working now. Sweet. Sorry for the yelling. If everyone can grab the med students and partners can grab a cider and a glass, that would be great. Thanks. And we'll start at 11:45 sharp. So continue the merriment.
Hi. Yes, Sam. Hey, thank you. You too.
Exciting. Thank you. Can't go back up there.
No, it's going to go out for you guys to. Who's doing the toast?
Aaron. He's in a brown corduroy. He'll be up here.
Yeah, I just want to give him this. That's why.
Oh, okay. We'll all be standing there while Sue Harper and Dean Compton are talking.
Okay, I'll just stand over that side. You just tell me.
Thank you. and get our envelopes. Let's see. So those are
Dwayne's.
These are yours.
I got the easy.
I did most of them. This one's going to be the random one at the bottom.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. So they're in order. Last year I dropped. Forgot it was.
Come on, go green, yes. Hello? I think you can hear me. Dr. Harper would like to say a few words.
I'd like to welcome everyone to this great Match Day celebration for the class of 2016. And at noontime, we can distribute the envelopes, which Dean Compton and I have randomized, ready to go. Before we get started, though, I'm going to say a few words about our presentation for the next few minutes as we pass the moments up to noontime. I'll be followed by Dean Compton, who will say a few words. We have Ian and Aravid, who will also be speaking. And then Aaron, Big Door, will be leading the class in a toast to sparkling cider, which is always a really nice way to bring us up to the hour. Let me just tell you a little bit about after the toast, what happens. At exactly noon, and Dean Compton has the clock on his iPhone, we can distribute the envelopes, and this has become a tradition the way we do this. We call down individuals in random order, and I made sure it was random. And what will happen is each student is called down, they've chosen a song that will accompany them and reflect whatever. Something. There's a wide variety. So, and we have, fortunately, your classmates of Luca, Pushball, and Rachel will all be leading the music, so they recognize you guys and we'll be able to keep it on track. Additionally, as you come down, we have a tradition too. There's this crystal ball, a bowl rather. And
thinking about your future right now, aren't you? Wishing for a crystal ball.
I do. And as people come down, they'll put a dollar into the bucket if they want to, and then the last person called will be rewarded the contents of the bowl for their patience. So there's a little bit of variation today. I saw Ian hung this pinata, which I understand is filled with Smarties and dummies, candy, dum-dums rather. And I think Ian will explain what he wants to do. That's a little twist. We've never had that, so watch out, guys. And I don't know, maybe they can give you some rules if it breaks. I don't know if everyone comes running, that could be exciting. So you want to be careful. So in addition, when the students get their envelopes, really it's up to the student how they would like to read their, if they would like to read their envelope. And if they do, we have a microphone right here. And feel free to open your envelope and read that. And many times students do. We also have a lot of students who don't want to read their envelope in public. And that's really important to respect, and they'll be walking, they may want to leave, or they may want to go join family and friends up in the audience. So just to know that there's really no set pattern on how to do that, and no one should feel pressure that they should open their envelope in front of that microphone. We are live streaming right now on YouTube, and I think the first and second year class can watch it over in, I think they're over in Kellogg watching it right now. Families from all over the country and world are watching this too. So I think this is great, so you can know that your families can see, you know, what's happening. After we finish the presentation, there's a reception, I think, with cupcakes outside to celebrate your many accomplishments. Congratulations to all of you, and Dean Compton.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. I first have to acknowledge Dr. Harper and all the team that helps put this together. I think you've all gotten really to understand how much we put behind supporting the students and making sure that you do well. So I want to thank her and the team for doing that. So I know you're really anxious to get started. And I'm going to keep my comments very brief, but we're going to have to wait until noon. So first of all, I want to start by just thanking all the family and friends that are here today. This is really a big moment, and I'm not sure you always know how much support the family and friends provide to the students going through the program, and that's incredibly important for the students. It takes a village, as they say, and so I look in the audience and I see a lot of those villages here to support these students, so thank you so much. I would also like to take a moment to recognize Jen and Peter Brock, who are here. They actually are responsible for creating the Merton Scholarship, which has actually been supportive of probably a quarter to a third of your classes has benefited from that scholarship. So I invited them here today so that they sort of could see the tangible results of their support that they provide for our students. So thank you for joining us today. So it wasn't that long ago that you were all thinking about where would I go to medical school. Time flies pretty fast, actually, and here we are thinking about taking the next step. I just want you to think a bit as you reflect on that decision that you made several years ago. And I actually would trust that you feel like this experience has been fulfilling for you, and that you've gained a lot and accomplished a lot since you've been here. I know that you're excited to see these envelopes and what's going to foretell your future, but I would like you to just take a moment to reflect and appreciate everything that you've done. And for as much as time and effort that the faculty and staff have put into you, have put into your training and your learning to become clinicians, I think equally you have contributed back to our community, not just in Geisel, but the whole community. And so I would actually like to extend my thanks to you, to all of the students who actually made that decision to come here and made that decision to be part of our community. It's a really tight-knit group, and I'm really pleased that you did that. So finally, of course. Finally, let me be the first to congratulate you on each one of you on your impending match. I think it's going to turn out very well for you, and I would like to say on behalf of all of it's the crystal bowl. I would like to say on behalf of all the faculty and staff how proud we are of each one of you. You've done such good work here, and we know we're confident that you're going to do outstanding work when you go forward. So we're really proud of you, and congratulations to all of you.
Hey, y'all. I won't use a mic, so that doesn't happen. We are the class representatives. I'm Ian. Marvin. We should really be celebrating is Dr. Harper here, who has done a ton of work. I can't imagine anything much more stressful than what she's been through with all of us. Yeah. So to ease the tension, we have gotten you some flowers, some truffles, a massage. And now we'll turn it over to the man of the hour, the toaster, Aaron. So at the end of this,
thank you, Dr. Harper. Thank you, Dr. Compton. Thank you, friends. Thank you, faculty. And of course, thank you, class of 2016, for nominating me to to be the last person standing in the way of you and the culminating experience of your 4 years of medical school. You know, in the past 6 weeks since we've come back together and had class, we've had time for reflection. And it's clear that we've done some serious work getting to this point. You know, last night I pulled out my abacus and I crunched the numbers and I found that we've internalized material from over 4,000 hours of lecture. Of course, that number seems less impressive when you realize that most of us did that in our pajamas at twice speed. But even so, I think it's an important testament to the knowledge that we've accrued. And our clinical training has been similarly robust. Reviewing my OASIS checklist for my rotations, I can attest to personally having written 8 H&Ps. And having seen literally dozens of patients in my four years of medical school. But we know what prepares us for what lies in those envelopes can't be measured in classroom time or ward experience. We are the culmination of attributes and elements earned by overcoming a series of pressing, but at times intangible trials. For some, our trials came early. For some, our trial came and we maintained heroic patience as a 5-minute PBL presentation ran into its grueling 23rd minute. For some, it came and we maintained composure over internal screams as Dr. Nuremberg congratulated our class on completing a round of finals, except for the few who didn't, but have yet to be notified, but maybe notified before the end of the business day today, but if not today, perhaps tomorrow? Others were more fortunate. Others found their trials came during the clinical years. For them, it was the courage to say no when confronted with a second free breakfast at CPMC and the staunch restraint to save room for the free lunch at noon conference. Others were tested in the operating room where they were called upon their wells of perseverance and retracted far longer than they thought humanly possible, straining muscles so obscure they had to consult their netters afterwards to localize the source of their burn. But perhaps the greatest trial we faced as a class was when we pulled together and supported each other through the tragic loss of one of our own. These are the virtues that will serve us in our future: patience, composure, temperance, perseverance, heart. When these powers combine, we summon the best versions of ourselves, some sort of hero perhaps, but I digress. You asked me to speak about this moment, right now, as we come forward to receive our first postings as physicians and surgeons. I feel the only way I can do this moment justice is to frame it within the context I know best. I feel like we're like Luke Skywalker in Star Wars Episode 4 as he and the Rebellion assault the Death Star. We have, despite fierce resistance, begun our descent into the trench, hurtling forwards towards our ultimate goal. Our targeting computer is set and calculating the distance to the exhaust port, and with clenched teeth and trembling hands, we man the triggers of our proton torpedoes. In this moment, I invite us to take a breath. I invite us to turn off our targeting computers. Use the force. Trust in our instincts. Become at peace with ourselves and the future ahead of us as we fire our proton torpedoes, detonate the paper enclosure, and grasp our destiny inside. Remember that we've accomplished so much, these are just the first few steps of storied careers as doctors and or Jedi. Some of us may even have to defeat future Death Stars for fellowship, and I don't know how I'm going to be able to incorporate Ewoks into that speech, but that's a speech for another time. For now, class of 2016, let me say this. May the Force be with us, always. L'chaim!
Thank you.
Yes, wherever you want it.
All right, so lastly, the pinata thing. After you open your envelope, if you so choose, you may pick up the baton and smash the pinata. Maybe go to downward angle so it's not like all up and down. This angle. That's how it works.
Great. What time is it?
We're good to go.
Is it on the clock? Harris,
Thanks.
Hey guys, it's my sister. She's my good luck charm. Going into internal medicine at my number one NYU.
Okay, no more piñata. Next up is Ilana Pryor.
At Cornell.
Congratulations. Next envelope is for Evelyn Bay. Next envelope is for Yin Yang.
Together, so our first couple is Wade and Asha.
pediatrics.
And I'm going into OBGYN. At Utah!
Our next envelope is for Anna Hua.
One, but if you really want to go somewhere else, please know that's fine. Christine Torres Lockhart.
Brigham and Women's.
The next envelope is Sari Khalil.
At University of Minnesota.
Next is Lynn Simon.
Next is for Charis Ripley Hager.
So I'm going into general surgery at
Happy Birthday, Beautiful Abington Memorial.
Alexandra and Chris and Kathy.
Surgery here at Dartmouth.
Next is Edith Lee Barnes.
Hi,
medicine here at Dartmouth.
Next is Aaron Steen.
Dermatology, University of California, San Francisco.
Next is Victor Lorian.
Things, what I'm going into and where I'm going. I'm going into pediatrics and emergency medicine at Tucson.
Next we have Ready.
Surgery at University of Rochester.
Next envelope is Phoebe Kahn.
At the University of Pennsylvania.
Next is Jess Rush.
Yeah! Next is Matthew Wesley.
To internal medicine at Dartmouth Hitchcock Medical Center.
Ready? do you pronounce
our next one? Envelope is for Kelly Michelson.
How do you pronounce
it?
Thank you.
Just like it's written.
Thank you.
Next envelope is for Baratu Adam.
Vascular surgery at Dartmouth Hitchcock.
Next is Rachel LaRocca. Next is Arvind Viswanathan.
To urology at University of Wisconsin, Madison.
The next envelope is for Brian Piper.
Plastic surgery at Duke.
Next is Zane Ulabedin.
So thank you again for a wonderful 4 years. I'll be opening the envelope in private, but thank you.
Next is Ayo.
$2 for Ain Young, by the way. So I was actually thinking, and at first I thought I was going to actually go outside and read this to my family, but I have family here today. So Tolu, can you come read this for me, please? I have to remember how to read. Emergency medicine at BI Dickens. Yeah!
Next is Nagin Janish. Next, we have a couple, Emily and Barad.
At the University of California, San Francisco.
Next is Shreya.
Mass Gen Hospital.
Next is Afton Chavez. Next envelope is for Amelia Noble.
Children's National in DC.
We have another couple, Jason and Sam.
Next is George Bodziak.
I'm doing internal medicine at Vanderbilt.
Next is for Amy Chabotnoy.
Swedish Seattle Indian Health Board.
Next is Chelsea Weinstein.
Next is Shadia Karim. Next is Rachel Condath.
At Mount Sinai.
Next envelope is for Jisoo Kim.
Well, is next.
this is as much for them as for me.
University of Wisconsin.
So the next is a couple, Samantha and Andrew.
So first off, hello to our families watching in England, Chicago, and Niagara Falls. I've already matched in ophthalmology at Case Western in Cleveland, and we're gonna read each other's envelopes. Samantha has matched in Case Western Rainbow Babies in Cleveland.
Yeah. And Drew has matched at Case Western Medicine.
Next is Asha Lichtman.
Next envelope is for Manisha. Next envelope is for Vignesh.
That's a theme song to Car Talk for the uninitiated. Warlord, a.k.a. my sister.
So my baby brother is going to be doing general surgery at Duke.
Next is David and Anna.
Next envelope is for Neil Patel. Yeah.
Thoracic surgery at Cleveland Clinic.
I think it's me. Tony Pang. Next is Fed Gully.
I'm going to read this. No, I'm just kidding. I'm going to urologic surgery at the University of California at San Diego.
And to Nancy and Connor, know you're out there too. Thank you guys. I matched into emergency medicine at Denver Health in Colorado.
Next is Ian Engler.
Woo! Latin counter.
Yep.
Thank you, Dr. Pepper.
Hi there. I'm going into orthopedic surgery at Tufts.
Next is Alex Norshad.
Who's watching from California? Oh my god. I matched at Beth Israel. Oh, sorry. Icon School of Medicine, Beth Israel at for psychiatry.
Next is Jesus.
For me, doing family medicine. Shout out to my family in Washington State.
Jesus is going to Lawrence.
Yeah!
Next is Bridget Curley. Next is Joanna Cobb.
have Emily and Rex.
So I matched back in December, so I guess it's fine to wait to the end. I'm going into general surgery at Walter Reed.
That's in Maryland. I matched at Children's National.
Next is Patrick Chen.
Okay, all right. First, it's my birthday, big 26. Shouts out to my parents watching on the West Coast and my mom for bringing me into this world. 2016, we did it. I'm going into neurology. UC San Diego, what?
Critical care combined. They're not going to be able to keep us straight at University of Washington.
Next is Rebecca Wang. Next is for Katarina.
minutes to go, so I have Chase Ascot.
I'm going into radiation oncology, and we'll be at
Emory.
Okay, process of elimination. So, Joseph. You don't have to put it in there.
Dino, don't worry, that's going right in the 401k. I'll never see that. I'm going into combined internal medicine pediatrics at Yale New Haven.
Congratulations to all of you, and we can now celebrate, starting with our reception in the hallway, which I know you'll be celebrating later this evening, and have fun with that too. So congratulations to everyone. If you'd like a master list, both Polly and Allison have the list, so come and find her, and if you'd like to just kind of keep track of where all your classmates have gone.
Congratulations, everyone. Yeah!